This is the first step will be to remove this cover from the bumper. So this guy originally goes like that, and there, not all the P2 Volvos are the same, but this one you can remove the cover. I started on the side like this. You just go with a butter knife or something like this, go gently. You see the clips how they are. They pop out pretty easily, so I prefer starting at one corner and then just pull it and follow all the displays. As you can see, it kind of goes underneath, but we just push it like pull it like that and just pray a little bit. Let's have a look at the. This is how it's attached there. So at the rear it has these hooks, and towards the front of the car is more like tubs like that. So it's really not hard to remove. I'm not sure what this thing is. Anyhow, so once removed, you need to clean it with use some lacquer thinner or Aston. Clean it real well, and then glue the metal band. Important thing, if you want it to work properly, is to glue it such way as the strip to be very, very vertical. So that's why I push it down there. It's vertical. You don't want to be to make an angle with the vertical, because it won't detect objects. And then I want to pass. I use a wire like this. There was already a crack in there, and so I want to pass my wire to connect here. I want to pass it there, so I'm just using a steel wire like that to get through the something, and then I'm gonna pull on the wire and pull this guy out. So then this guy connects to the metal strip on the bumper cover. Then this is, sorry, this is the piece, I'm not sure, the module from the parking sensor. And you need to connect it properly, and then one wire goes to the buzzer itself, which I placed somewhere in the top here, I don't remember well. And then the two wires, the other wire goes to the you can see it, black and blue wires. I stripped them down, and it's better to use a soldering iron. Oh, there's two more things. The module, you want to place it such way to be away at least 2 inches from any metal part, so that the module, the thick, the black box, you want it to place it somewhere to be away, like at this place is kind of away 2 inches at least from any metal part for it to work properly. When you put a cover back, make sure don't bend the rear tabs like I just did. I think you'll need to start first with these tabs, engage them, otherwise they're gonna bend and it's not gonna work. So press in carefully each one of these tabs all around the cover, and then just slip this over. So it's almost done. So I got all the tabs. That's where it's attached, the sensor. And for this portion here, you just need to press this down like that, and then crush this, pushing towards the front of the car. It's not fun. Something like that. Honestly, this is way harder than installing the sensor itself. So keep going on like this. So let's see how good is this parking sensor strip. So I got an SUV behind me, so the bumper, it's already pretty high, but it works the same for all cars. So let's reverse slowly.
So at this point, you got a beep beep. Let's go out and see how far we are. That's like 1.5 feet maybe. And now let's reverse again. You'll hear the same beep, and then as you get closer, the beep will be constant, will be a constant sound. So as you can see, it's really a couple of inches, maybe 6 inches or so. That's the constant beep. What's nice is that this thing also works when you are doing a parallel parking and when you are going to an angle with the other cars. And again, you got the beep. Let's see how it sits.
You can see that the car is oblique.
You see the distance again, it's about 1 foot or something like this. Right now my car is at an angle. Basically the strip goes like this, and I put a little bit of it like that at the corner, not too much, just a short length, and I can just feel the other car even at an angle. Obviously no system is perfect. I didn't have problems with mine except when it's raining. When it's raining and there's water on the bumper, I guess it's just beeping when I reverse it for a couple of seconds. Never been annoying to me. But always pay attention if there are people crossing behind your car, kids, children, cats, whatever. You should never take your eyes from watching behind your car when you are reversing. Always keep it safe.